Hello again, my lovely listeners and cuddly little questioners. Yes, we're finally back. It is time for Series 2 of Ask Uncle Ben. We're all here again. There's me, there's Whistler over there, Fagin's under the bed. There's all sorts going on. Oompa Loompas in the cupboard. What a wonderful thing it is to be back with you. I hope you've all been exceptionally well since our sound waves last touched your ears. And now, let us begin with this first episode, as we've had a few lovely questions already. First of all, from Simon Webb. Hello again, Simon. What's your favourite song by Atomic Kitten?
Yes.
Good old Atomic Kitten. Them, of course. I think, didn't they do... Oh, I like that, yes. Didn't they do Love Machine? I like that one. I'm just a love machine. Lick me like mint ice cream. Cover me in tureen. Blah, 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 etc. I like that a lot. What? Isn't it? Sorry, Whistler's advising me. It's not them. Oh, bugger. Well, who in the name of tits are Atomic Kitten, then? Oh, God, them. In which case, I think my favourite song of theirs would be the one between tracks 3 and 4 on their first album. That lovely bit of silence. Very nice. Another question from Simon. Eager. Why did Little Caesar's Pizza never make it in the UK market? Conversely, why did Pizza Hut? Well, I'm afraid it's often the way with these things, Simon, isn't it? They were so successful in the US of A that they relied purely on their success there. Didn't bother to put anything into marketing in this country. Didn't advise their franchise over here at all. It was arrogance and laziness, that's why. Have I just answered the question properly, almost? How ridiculous. I'm sorry. Maybe it was because we've never quite got over the occupancy by the Romans in this country, so we didn't like Little Caesar. Whereas Pizza Hut, everyone loves a hut full of pizzas. Apart from me, I hate pizza. But there we are. Hope that answers your question. Mummy Ram. Hello again, Mummy Ram. Mummy Ram asks, why, when I booked a holiday, did no one tell me it would rain for 10 days almost solidly? Oh dear. Let's just put two sort of bemused faces. I don't know. I can't get the hang of these emoticons. Well, you know what they say, Mummy. Rain on your holiday, shepherd's pie. Yes, that's what they say, isn't it? But clearly you haven't been listening to the news at Ben, have you, Mummy Ram? That my nephew does, you see. Well, I do, neither is anybody else. Never mind. So you're not alone there. But on there, you see, there's Melanie Fruitlumps, who does the weather. She also does the finance and the traffic and travel. She's a multi-talented woman. Actually, I wonder if I can get her in here. If I call through to the next studio. Studio, I'm in a bedroom. Jesus, I need a job. Right. Melanie, could you come here, please? Hello. Yes, come along. Oh, you've brought your own music with you. That's very kind of you. Thank you.
Hi, Uncle Ben.
Hello there, my dear. How the devil are you?
I'm fine, thanks.
Jolly good. Now, we've got Mummy Ram here, and she's had 10 days solid rain on her holiday, and she's not very happy about it.
Oh, dear. Well, of course, it's difficult not knowing where you're on holiday, but as the old sayings go, the rain in Spain falls mainly on the plain. The rain in France falls mainly on the plants. The rain in the UK falls mainly every day. The rain in Czechoslovakia, falls mainly in the past, because it's the Czech Republic now. And my accent is questionable. I hope that helps.
Thanks very much, Melanie. Ta-ta.
Bye-bye.
Well, Mummy Ram, you couldn't get more help than that, could you? Be quiet. Right, moving on immediately. Jen. Hello, Jen. Jen says, salad dressing must have or devil spawn. Well, in order to have salad dressing, you have to have salad, don't you? So I would say devil spawn. I am not eating leaves. I am not a diplodocus. Do you hear me? I am not a diplodocus. Only good. Mrs. Suspicious Coffee Mornings writes in. Hello again. She says, total eclipse of the hut. Explain. Oh dear. I think I feel a song coming on. Music, please, Whistler.
Slap the ground. Every now and then I get a little bit lonely and I wanna hide away. Slap the ground. Every now and then I get a little bit tired and I want some place where I can sit down.
Slap the ground.
Every now and then I get a little bit nervous cause I have nowhere to put all my tools.
Slap the ground.
Every now and then I get a little bit terrified but then I see the space on my lawn.
Slap the ground and add drainage.
Every now and then I just feel
slap
dead.
Slap the ground and add drainage.
So every now and then I build a shed, and I'm building one tonight. And the neighbors will be jealous, cause it'll have an outside light, and a veranda and a trellis. And I know I'll be building it right, cause I've read the instructions. I'm gonna paint it blue and varnish it so fine. And if the paint's too thick, then I'll just add turpentine. I know just what to do, I'm never in the dark, cause it's got light and power and space for us so far. I'm building heaven tonight, yes heaven's gonna start tonight. Oh heaven's gonna start tonight. Once upon a time I had a little lean-to with a squeaky door that would never shut. But now I've got this shed, it's a total eclipse of the heart. Once upon a time I had nowhere to go. Now my shed palace is the absolute nuts. Nothing I can say, total eclipse of the heart.
Well, that's more than enough of that nonsense. A song about a shed. Entirely thrilling. Right, moving on. Dear Uncle Ben, why is it so hard to find facilities for recycling dust? I have literally hundreds of hoovers bursting at the seams with useful detritus that could be converted into a convection heater or a new Chancellor of the Exchequer. And yet I am stymied at every turn. Yours sincerely, Suckmaster Bursting Foam. Brackets ghost.
Oh,
nice to hear from a ghost. Well, what a spirited question. Stop it at once. Dust recycling plants are few and far between. That's the problem, isn't it? However, I suggest going to your local garden centre. There's a plant there called the Hoover's Revenge. Its Latin name is Reusibus Flappy Dust. Not to be confused with Asparagus Minibus, which is entirely different, although quite delicious. Buy some of those. They are literally dust recycling plants. Put them in your house. I mean, if you go to a house full of houseplants, you don't see any dust, do you? And you can't see anything. But what you can do is you can empty your Hoover bag, or if it's bagless, you empty the Hoover, or one of these Hooverless Hoovers you get now, which is a power cord. Empty that onto the plant, and the next day you might have a new suit, or even a second-hand car. Hope that helps there. Another question from Mummy Ram. Now that we are not part of the EU, can we once again enjoy curly cucumbers? My experience tells me they taste far superior. Oh yes, Mummy, don't you worry, yes. We can have our curly cucumbers once more. Yes, just picture the scene, Mummy Ram. A warm summer's day. The smell of freshly cut grass in the air. Sat amongst England's pleasant mountains green. A cup of tea in one hand, a curly cucumber sandwich in the other, savouring each delicious bite as the economy collapses around us, racists and xenophobes on every corner. That perfect sound of willow on leather as cricket is played from dawn till dusk, whilst unemployment rises and much-needed funding falls. How we'll laugh as our human rights are violated even further by our horrific Tory government, with no one now to stop them. How we'll frolic merrily in the empty fields as farmers' subsidies are all but abolished, and many people won't even be able to afford the most basic food items. How content we will be with our curly cucumbers, as the poor-rich divide widens even further, and our once beautiful multicultural society becomes a stifled, bland, and insular shadow of its former self. But we shall hold our curly cucumbers proud, Mummy Ram, yes we will! for this is our Eden. This is our green and pleasant land. This is our England.
Right, well, that's all we've got time for today on Ask Uncle Ben, so take care of yourselves, won't you, and indeed each other. And don't forget to ask Uncle Ben. And I think we'll finish with a little bit of Girls Aloud and Love Machine, because I love it. Sing along, everybody. Bye-bye!
Heading for war.
Nobody's perfect. We all gotta work it. As fellas, we're worth it. So don't break the law. Your call's late. Big mistake. You gotta hang about in limbo for as long as I take. Next time, between my mind, and I'll be good to you. Wet gift, wrap, kitty cat. The only thing that makes tigers when we got a fright back. And let's go, Eskimo. I'll be into the blue. Come meet my dreams, honey, hard as it seems. Love and peace.
It's as easy as pie.
I'm just a love machine, feeding my fantasy. Cover me in terrine. Ba-ba-doo-ba-dee-ba-la-boo. I'm just a love machine, of all of you.
Ba doo ba da ba dee boo.
I need a squeeze and taste. And if this makes a change, what will the neighbors say?
Ba doo ba da ba dee boo.
Little extra time. Tell us the situation. Now
hold on.
Cause I don't wanna change ya.
Bee ba ba.
Maybe you're a stranger. I'll only be a ranger. But now,
I'll live alone. The machine.
I'd like to point out I'm not in fact a love machine, just for the record.
Marvellous, marvellous, marvellous.